I believe question 11 is the very last question from OpenStax. The rest are the questions from a different textbook and some questions that I've written. And what it is the questions in OpenStax don't really go into the level of difficulty I want it to go into. That's why these additional questions are there. And some of the beginning ones won't be all that hard, but as you go into especially the last few, you will find that they are difficult. As in, if you try to, so questions like this one, if you are just trying to write down E is equal to gamma mc squared, and momentum is equal to gamma mv, and you are trying to work through the algebra after applying conservation of energy and momentum, what you'll find is that it's really easy to get lost in the algebra. So that's why it's important, if you haven't already, for you to look at this note that was posted. That's why I did this. This was my highest priority until it was done, because this contains information that's necessary for you to finish the homework assignment. Your textbook doesn't cover it. I needed to cover it. I mean, I kind of covered it in lecture, but you need to have something that's written that you can refer to. And that's what this is. And some of the things we have definitely mentioned in class, you know, four vectors, and that energy and momentum form a four vector, and that there's a Lorentz invariant. Like, all of these were mentioned in class, but what we didn't have a lot of time going over, and you really need a written material to refer to, is how these apply in the context of problem solving. So look through it. Some of the examples we actually looked at in class, like redshift starlight, it's a version of what we did in class. So, you know, skip it if you want, skim it if you want to. But the questions that'll become quite similar to the questions you need to do on the homework assignment are the last few. It kind of ramps up to it, so do read it in order. But it's the last few examples. So this one is one where, sorry, I realized it as I was answering someone's question that I didn't draw any figure. That's why you kind of have to read it through it. Draw your own figure. This one describes collision between a stationary target with an energetic target coming and hitting it. This is like one or two of your homework questions. And the approach, calculation approach you see here will be very different from the one that you might intuitively do starting from this. It's because I'm treating energy and momentum as proper four vectors. And the thing that I start out by calculating is I start out by calculating the Lorentz invariant instead of going through this expression. I mean, at some point it comes in. So at this point, I do bring in that energy is expressed as this. But it's not until the very end that it actually comes into a vector. So when you do special relativity calculations, really the number one thing I would say, try to avoid this, is getting bogged down in algebra. If you are finding that you need to do pages of algebra to do a problem, chances are there's a better way. Whatever you're doing, you know, this is what I used to call soft error in physics 4A, as in you are doing something wrong, but not in any identifiable way. You are not making any algebra mistakes. You haven't written down anything that's wrong, except in the sense that you are not getting towards the answer. And when you get stuck in that, this is part of the problem solving skill that you need to develop. When you get stuck in something like that, you need to recognize, all right, this isn't working. You need an entirely new approach. And what these examples are giving you is that entirely new approach. Algebraically, these are actually very simple, but what they are more complex in is the sort of the mathematical tool that it's using. So take a look at it. This will help. And